Thank you. So the topic of today's talk is trends and challenges of augmented reality. And I guess I've already mentioned augmented reality as an emerging field that is now creating a lot of public interest already in the morning. So you kind of know what's coming. So since I'm the only person who keeps you from the drink hour, maybe let's start with something entertaining, a little quiz. Who knows the name of this device? Yes, of course, that's too easy. That's the Microsoft HoloLens. It's, if I want to describe it, a head-worn device for augmented reality. Now, the noteworthy thing about that is really that Microsoft is coming forward and making this massive investment. I mean, nobody knows, but if you talk to people, you learn that all these projects like Oculus Rift and Google Glass, which was mentioned in the morning, and also the HoloLens are investments of hundreds of millions of dollars each. So this is certainly noteworthy insofar as these big IT companies are making these kind of activities and investments, and therefore you can believe that the time is now ready for this to become a real technology, not just a niche technology. So just to give you a little bit of background, here's a very, very simplified attempt at characterizing how augmented reality works. So the general idea or the definition, if you want, is that you overlay the real world with computer graphics and you do that in real time and in real space in three dimensions, so to speak. And that requires, well, obviously a feedback loop between the human and the computer. So let's say we start with what is typically called post-tracking, that is you determine where the display, whether a head-worn display or a handheld display or some other kind of display, is in the space right now. And then you can use that information to register the virtual content with the real world. Of course, ideally, you would also want some knowledge of the real world, which is where this spatial model here comes into place. And then if you have this registration, you perform something that I like to call situated visualization. That's actually a term invented by Sean White, not myself. And that describes visual information that is delivered in a particular place, in a natural place. And so the place where you put the information is also important. And then it's user input, that's of course three-dimensional input. I just browsed through the posters and there's lots of